Secret Service, starring Colin Firth, Taron Egerton, and Samuel L. Jackson, because he's in everything these days. The film was directed by Matthew Vaughn. He's the director of movies like Kick-Ass, X-Men's First Class, and also Layer Cake. The basic synopsis of this movie is kind of a make-up or play-on of the spy genre. It has Taron Egerton's character, Eggsy, that is his real name, and it takes place in London, and his father, who is a part of the Secret Service, died before that, so Colin Firth's character has to go recruit him because one of their other agents died at the beginning of the movie. And basically, it goes through his training and also his overall mission that will probably have to save the entire planet. This movie is over the top, and it is kind of silly. It's kind of ridiculous. But saying that, it's pretty awesome. I actually really like this movie a lot. Let's just get that out. Let's just get this out of the hat, alright? Colin Firth was probably the best in this movie. I've never seen him play such a badass. But now he's finally showing that he actually can do some stunts. He did, like, I think 80% of his stunts, and he can do action, and he's good in acting as well in the movie. And Taron Egerton was also amazing. I've never seen him before in any of his movies before. Really great as a physical presence, but also his character and how he showed his kind of young and innocent kind of character in him. But I think that Samuel L. Jackson still did a pretty good job in this movie, considering his villain kind of figure, because he's usually Nick Fury and he's like a good guy, but now he's a bad guy. And as the film progressed, I kind of liked his character more and how he portrayed his character with his like little different kind of speaking dialects and also his kind of humor, because this character is really humorous and all that kind of stuff. And there's a lot of interesting characters in this movie. There's a lot of different villains. There's the sidekick for Samuel Jackson's character. I think her name is Gazelle, having prosthetic limbs, but they have blades in them. She can cut people's arms off, and she can stab people, and it was awesome. She was probably one of my favorite villains of the movie. And she's not the only interesting character, because every character in this story has some kind of interesting factor in them, because they're all, the training people are all young, and they're all in their 20s, and they're trying to get in with life. And then Taron Egerton's character, Eggsy, he kind of is like parkour, but then he's Marines, but then he's also, like, supernatural powers where you can fight crime and all that stuff, and he was awesome. Colin Firth has all these gadgets, and it really kind of connected to the James Bond back in the 60s and the 70s, where it was kind of cheesy, kind of different, and also I think it has a good strong idea of what the modern society is and how we are connected to our phones and how the phones and how the internet and basically how data and all that kind of thing could be also a dangerous thing to us. Especially when they end up making us try to kill each other. The stunt coordination and the direction from Matthew Vaughn in this movie is probably one of its best parts of the movie. Because it's hard to really do shaky cam right. Only Paul Greengrass can kind of do that right. But Matthew Vaughn is good with the camera. He has good shots. He has good settings. And Matthew Vaughn did a really great job directing this movie. And also the dialogue in this movie was funny. It was witty. It was connecting back, like I said, to the Bond age. And it shows this kind of weird villain with weird limbs and some kind of different feature to their body. And also it shows like the funny side to spy movies and how funny it is and how kind of ridiculous some plots are. I would call this a comedy, but also it's really an action thrill ride with a lot of great special effects and stunts and all that. But really it is kind of a comedy because all these characters, when they interact, they always have these funny kind of dialogue, especially with Samuel L. Jackson and also Colin Firth. Colin Firth was hilarious in this movie, Manners Maketh Man. And then you know, the whole bar scene, that was a great scene. And overall, this movie just had great editing, great directing, great performances, and great writing. Now here goes to the things that were kind of ridiculous, because this movie's already ridiculous in general. So Samuel Jackson's villain, I think his name is Valentine. It's a weird name, right? But it's also kind of a funny name. Like I said, his plan is basically to put this chip into everybody's phone and sell it for free, which basically enables them to have free Wi-Fi, free data everywhere they go. And then he kind of has this, like, biochemic thing inside of them, and basically when he presses this button and it countdowns, people who have the phone and they're around them, they go on a homicidal rampage and they try to kill whoever's around them. So yeah, that's kind of a pretty... it's kind of pushing some boundaries, and I knew that Matthew Vaughn wanted to push boundaries in this movie, but just the idea of humans killing humans and that would eventually lead to the extinction of humans just didn't really kind of work for me, and I kind of thought that was a little bit too much. Maybe he could have like blew up an iceberg or something. And also the fact that he was contacting all of these like powerful people. He was contacting the President of the United States, Barack Obama, as a reference. Didn't show his face, just the back of his head. He contacted people in all the countries, and he was just like, "We're gonna gather together. You're gonna let me do this. A bunch of people are gonna die. Millions and billions of people are gonna die. And we're going to sit in this nice lounge or your bunkers and we're going to watch all this happen." Why the heck would people agree to that? I don't know. And they could have just took that out and had more action sequences that actually looked real and weren't CGI. I don't know, maybe that. But besides that, the movie is supposed to be that way. It's supposed to be different. It's kind of has that comedic but also really strange and kind of like Kick-Ass. Like Kick-Ass was a really weird movie, but I loved it a lot. Because the stylish action and violence kind of just showed a really different approach to how superheroes are. And this showed a lot different to how spies are and how they just kill literally every single person in sight. But besides that, this movie is exciting. It's entertaining. I liked it a lot. I probably want to watch it again to see if I can think of anything else. But really, I like this movie a lot for its directing, its performances by Colin Firth especially, its stunt coordination, its cinematography, kind of, because it had great direction and editing. And the only thing I just kind of thought was some parts of the story that just kind of were too over the top. But either way, I still liked it a lot. And I'm going to give it a B+, because mostly just because of the parts of this. That's my review for Kingsman, The Secret Service. Subscribe, guys. Comment below. Tell me what you thought about this movie. Give me some feedback and all that. And otherwise, I'll see you guys later. Thank you for watching.